In this video, you'll see how to optimize Apache Iceberg tables with AWS Glue Data Catalog. With this feature, you can automate the heavy lifting to keep your Apache Iceberg tables optimized, resulting in reduced storage costs and enhanced query performance. To begin, our architecture will have a Glue Data Catalog database, an Amazon S3 bucket, and an AWS Glue job that creates and modifies sample customer data in the S3 bucket, with a trigger every 10 minutes. We'll then enable Iceberg table optimizers in AWS Glue Data Catalog to enable managed retention and orphan file deletion for storage optimization. To create the resources, we deployed a publicly available AWS CloudFormation template, which can be found in the blog included in the description for this video. Let's look at the stack. The S3 bucket stores customer table data and metadata, which is added continuously by the AWS Glue job. The Glue job role manages AWS IAM access to the S3 bucket. The Glue job adds approximately 10,000 sample customer records to the S3 bucket every 10 minutes. A Glue trigger and a database were also created in the Glue data catalog. Let's view the job runs in the AWS Glue Studio. For demonstration purposes, we've been running jobs for a while. Let's view the objects in our S3 bucket. In the data folder, we have the Parquet data files added by the Glue jobs. New snapshots are created for every change to the data in the table. The metadata folder stores the JSON and AVRO files created with each Iceberg transaction. Now let's view the bucket metrics. The total bucket size has increased by the day. Though the customer records are small in size, the bucket is already storing more than 4 terabytes of data. Similarly, the number of objects kept has steadily increased. Next, we'll view the table details in the AWS Glue console. The customer table is stored in the Iceberg Blog DB database in Apache Iceberg format. The location is our S3 bucket. We can view and manage the table schema from this page. The schema is simple, containing only column names and data types. Next, let's look at the Table Optimization tab. This is where we can configure the optimizers. We can selectively enable optimizers to compact small S3 objects into larger objects, to automatically delete expired snapshots and files, or to delete orphan files. In this case, we'll enable all the optimizers at once. Notice that all three optimization options are selected. Next, we can select our optimization configuration. When using the default settings, Data Catalog retains snapshots for 5 days and retains a minimum of 1 snapshot. Files associated with expired snapshots will be deleted, and orphan files will be deleted after 3 days. For this example, we'll customize the settings. First, we'll specify the IAM role that has access to the underlying S3 table. Next, we'll specify how many days we want to retain the snapshot. We'll reduce the number of days we want to retain the snapshot from 5 days to 1. We'll retain 1 snapshot and delete files associated with expired snapshots. Next, we'll reduce the number of days to keep orphan files before deleting them, from 3 days to 1. We'll acknowledge the caution and enable optimization. In order to compare our table with and without optimization during the same time period, we set up a replica architecture in a different region. Here are the optimization details for the customer's table. We've been running Glue jobs and can view the optimizer history. Let's view all the details for the orphan file deletion history. These files are no longer referenced or identified by Iceberg, so they are eligible for expiration. Our configuration runs the optimizers daily to clean up these files. Now let's see what the data looks like with optimization. With all three optimizers enabled, the bucket for the same customer's table running the same job for the same duration is now under 1 terabyte in total size. The size will keep increasing because the job is continuously adding more data. However, by compacting the data and removing unnecessary and unreferenced files, it can maintain a much smaller bucket size, Additionally, the total number of objects are 1/10 of what we had without optimizers. With this set of optimizers, we can save on storage costs and improve query performance since there are fewer files to query from. You've just seen how to optimize Apache Iceberg tables with AWS Glue Data Catalog. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.